Okay, so we've got the queen, finally. Her markers have gotten worn off. We've got to reverse what we were doing here. We're just going to take them, if you have to, just get them. And then once the queen is there, we're going to check it and took it out. So now we're going to put everything back in order here. And hopefully, if everything goes right, we're going to make this queen think she's sworn. So somebody says, well, how are you going to do that? Well, when we get the box put back together, what we'll do is lay the queen. We'll lay her down on top of the nuke box over here. And she's in this form mode. She looks like she is. And the bees will begin to swarm to her, just like a natural swarm, just like they swarmed out of the box on their own. And we've done this on several occasions. It may not work today, but any other time we've ever done it, it has worked and worked wonderful. The bees will just go right to the queen, and then that way you've got the appropriate amount of bees, and then if they want to add some room to this, we can go back and add to it. You see, probably most of them with the box. So if they're going to be longer without air. Heavy. We want to try to get them all back in with them. Try to be nice to them. Thank you.
So they're thinking about it, they're wanting to, and we may end up having to speed up the process.
Excuse the change in audio. I think my speakers is for today. It's flashing, saying it's dead. So the audio has changed.
It's wild. They're still thinking about it. It's just a few at a time. I don't know if anybody can see it on the camera. A few at a time, they come out, make a circle, go to her. It's just this bunch here just slow. There comes some more in, coming through the queen. We've done this in the past, and they just... she may have been a couple days away from swarming. Again, we didn't want to take a chance and wait on it. We've caught some. I evidently, on the day of, they were thinking about it, or within hours or something. When we've done this, it don't take but about 15 minutes, and you got your box of bees. These are, they're thinking about it. They're coming around a little slow. Halfway in the ocean, I think we ought to rebuild the box and see if that does anything. But I hate to put it all together and then tear it back apart to shake it.
Yeah.
So let's back up and do that, because that might be the worker bees. Maybe we had never done this without putting the box all the way back together. And I'm kind of tired, so I was kind of wanting to cut the corner and not put it all the way back together before we tried the swarmer. So just in case, we had to go back and do the shakeout and shake some in. But a lot of it could be because a lot of nurse bees are up in there tending brood. And we got the worker bees over here, a whole lot of them in two supers, so that could be our issue.
Yep. Possibility. Yep, that's one of them.
So a question to think about now. We'll let Jared see what he wants to do with this one. And the question is, put the queen excluder back on today or not to put the queen excluder on? I mean, smoking down something.
Okay. I think we'll just leave it on. And that way, hopefully, it'll keep all them young queens below the queen excluder.
Drone boy.
Yep.
Don't want to kill the drones if we can help it. Won't be fair. We'll shake them off. Clean the dead off.
Was that one not below the queen cellar today? I think there's a queen cellar too in there, maybe. Yep. Back you folks out here so you can see what's going on a little bit better now. We're just deciding we need to expedite a little bit, I reckon. A little further, that is. What they thinking?
And we just know what naturally is going to occur.
Just keep kind of creeping this stuff back a little bit. Trying to help them separate a little bit more.
Just go to show you when you think you got something figured out about bees, you better back up and figure something else out.
Back up and get it, grab a hold of these bricks. Yep. They say we're going to...
You know she's a good queen, she's gonna lay a lot. I would like to have some nurse bees in there with her. Maybe a frame of brood. He's got me. All that's gonna do in my opinion. I don't know, anybody can have their own opinion, but my opinion is what that's gonna do is going to let that queen have a jump start in growing this. Growing that nucleus out to get it in a timber box before the fall and the winter. It looks like take that frame in that box. It's the frame we wired back together.
She said, we have learned and people have told us that once you think you got it figured out about bees, they'll prove you wrong.
That's real good. That's the way to do it right there. Sit out of my hand.
Just real raw beekeeping, folks. That's all we can say.
I was looking
at the frame. You want You want the frame hanger?
Got the mind off the bees and drop the frame. But it happens, that's real world, it happens. I don't know how much Jared knows how to edit and un-edit and all that mess. I can tell you this much, if it's up to me, I don't know how to do it. So, you get any of that footage, it looks funny me doing something, and I know he didn't take it out. What was hunting is some brood. I'd like to send some nurse bees with her. Oop, we don't want to send that one. That's her next mama right there. I think you showed that, did you not?
Yeah, I showed you.
big old queen cell. So now what we do is, even though we're seeing this brood with her, I want to shake a few more bees in. So I'm getting a helper over here. She's, I guess she's going to stoke up the smoker a little better.
What you want to do with this?
Just hold it.
Bees are so crowded, box so crowded with bees, I don't think it's gonna hurt to check these bees.
Give her some extra, get up and going.
You gonna put this in the box with
them? Yeah, for anything for that. Bring any resources in?
Yeah, it's got some.
Got enough?
Yep. Excuse him having his back toward y'all. We'll recenter y'all back around this way here. So you can sort of see what's going on a little better.
We don't want to rob. We don't want to take everything.
Yeah, don't take everything from them at all. So they got some resources there. Good frame right there.
Barry don't mind, but the Barry he is saying this is not a how-to video, this is how we do videos. When it all works out right, it works. When it don't, we back up and figure out how to make it work.
Yep.
It is an ever-learning process. And I think I'm gonna get one. Hey.
It's up to you, Connor. I mean, I don't. Yeah.
That was
short.
That was too mean.
I don't know. You're the one playing this.
1, 2, 4, 5, 5. I'm going to come up the extra frame somehow with a good one.
Oh, you know, you got one right there.
Yeah, everything's got to move over because that one is going to be easy.
You're out 2 frames. I think.
Queen cells on the second.
Third one you said, or no, second one right there. You said it was 3 over though.
Like that, we're going to put it in anyway. It's the foundation. Oh, I had it waxed in good enough. It didn't need me.
Not.
I'm going to give it to them. That'll give them something to do while they're waiting on the new boy to come. The new boy behind us.
Back them up.
Give them something to do. Put this one right here.
Alright, smokes are coming.
Another good thing about taking some of the nurse bees that we have learned
is
because we may not move these 10 miles away or whatever. We've learned if we put nurse bees in, we don't have to go as far away to set this meat box in.
There'll be some workers probably, no doubt. We'll come back. I know what the theology is. I get it. You don't move them far enough, the workers will come back home and they'll leave.
Well, I guess there may be some of them do, but so far what we found here is going the way we're doing.
We'll take that box of bees and we'll take them less than a quarter of a mile away. And something could go wrong this time, I don't know. All I'd like to say is this. That's what we've been doing. We've had good success. We got nukes coming off, one in the 10 frame boxes. The point is, taking the nurse bees with us, we found, for the most part, those bees will stay with the queen, even the old workers. They'll stay with her when we set them down. They'll orientate where that box is, and they may be a few come back up here, but they won't even be enough to be noticed while that box that'll come back to the original height.
Again, now, I know that's contrary. Everybody's belief. That's what we have found out. It has worked for us. If it ain't broke, we don't fix it.
And there too, what works for our bees might not work for your bees.
That's true. As many houses we got, a lot of times.
Each one of them is different and has their own personality.
Their own personality. You leave this hive like this, go to the next hive and do what we just done. They may not like it, they may not accept it, they may not work. See, that is a very good point.
All of them are different.
Okie dokie. Now, these girls will figure out here, and they'll figure out by dark that their queen, their mama has swarmed, she is gone. They'll go to work, and they got the queen cell, so they were in preparation to get ready to swarm anyway. So we just sped up the process. That is all we have done. So, I hope you got something out of it. I hope you didn't get too crazy, too upside down. Apologize for taking so long to find the queen. And I hope she didn't do, or they didn't do what we were wanting them to do, and just see how that they just swarm out. Usually they do. This time it didn't. Maybe we got her a day or two early. She was
still laying pretty good.
Dump them out, let them get back in. They were still laying, she was still laying fairly good, let's put it that way. So, hopefully you got something, hope you learned something. Hopefully it's beneficial. Maybe you learned something not to do. If that's the case, then we're still a winner. Either way we go, we're a winner. If you learned something you shouldn't do, and you say, well, I shouldn't do that, I've tried it, don't work, well then, we just confirmed don't do it. But hopefully you've learned something, figured something out. That's the way we do it here. So far, that's the way we've done it. At 3B's and Green, and again, it's worked for us. I don't think we've lost a nook this year. Everything's stayed. So we've done something different than what we've been doing time past. It works, and we just want to let everybody in on it, let them see what we're doing. Anything else for you?
Give us a like and a subscribe if you find our videos and you like them. Thank you. 3B's in a Dream, Farm and Aviary, signing off.